I lost my temper. That's the only thing I am. And I'm willing to pay the consequences.
Wait a minute, sir. Let me hear what you did before you pay. Let me hear what you did.
I told him, if you don't have my money, I'll take $480 out of your Jeep. You can fix your Jeep whenever you want to fix your Jeep. You don't have to worry about paying me. And we're even.
And so
that's
what
exactly
did
what I did. I busted his Jeep up.
With a bat?
Yes, sir.
How in heaven's name, if he owed you $488, did you expect to limit the damage that you did to his Jeep to $488? Were you being very careful where you hit it? Say, this'll cost you $28. This'll cost you $60. This'll cost you $130. You didn't do that.
I went over to one fender. I said, that's $240. I said, you
that's
got
$240. Really? You counted it up?
He said, no. I said, Tony's been in the body business for 30 years.
You mean Tony was there saying, careful, it's over 240?
Yes, he was.
Is that what you said, Tony?
We kept good track of it.
We kept good track.
Well, you wake up in the morning. You hear the work bell ring. And I march you to the table. You see the same old thing. Ain't no food upon a table. There's no fork up in the pan. But you better not complain, boy.
Gets to pull away and an upset as Pat Musi defeats the number two car in the world.
Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me.
I should say that his two-tenths hole shot made that only 35 thousandths of a second at the finish line.
I guess I wasn't doing my job on the start line. Thank God I did my job under the hood. So.
It's just the way it is. I'm not going to change. You can forget that. I think everybody knows that. I'm never going to change. If I got something to say, I'm going to say it. And if you don't want to hear it, don't ask me.
So was Pat Musi a spoiled brat?
Not really. I let me tell you something. We moved diners. And I'll tell anybody this. I was in good shape. You could just go look at my, I hate to say it, but I'll just say it. My assault battery record was not good in them days.
That is warm.
Yeah. Look at that. Yeah. That's putting
hurt.
Well, now you're
coming up around them.
You must have hit that third system about there, right? Is it? He's got to be cheating, because I'm cheating and can't beat him.
Yeah.
I had to work a job, just like anybody, and working for my old man, I probably got fired once a week.
Yeah. And they're off, and it's Musi ahead of Clinton at the start. Musi, but Clinton starts to power by, and it's Clinton with yet another Cremona victory.
But it became a budget thing. I just really concentrated on racing. All I wanted to do was race. I didn't give a damn if my car payments were behind or my shop payments were behind. I mean, I was probably the only time in Indy that anybody out-qualified Gooden or Shepherd in NHRA in over 2 years. So we proved the point.
Why did Pro Street appeal to you? That was so far away from what you had done for years.
Well, I'm gonna tell you honestly, I'm sitting there at my desk one day, and I keep reading about Tony Christian winning this, winning that, winning this, looking at this deal. I see this Annette Summers, I don't know who she is. And I looked at my guys, we're having like, you know, we call it shop talk at night, you know. I said, look, if Tony is winning this deal, we could go over there and take over that deal.
You're a tough guy, aren't you?
I'm tough when I gotta be, let's put it that way. I don't back down from nobody, everybody knows that.
Have you ever lost a fight?
Oh yeah, hell yeah, we got jumped by, there was 15 of them and four of us, but we come back swinging.